Good morning. It's good to see you. Wanted to chat with you very briefly about a conversation I had last week. I was in a conversation with somebody that's being challenged by China. China's kind of shutting down and causing problems. We're fighting with them, tariffs, all this kind of thing. So one of the questions is, what do we do? What's a good contingency plan, a plan B, a rainy day plan? Whatever you want to call it, there's a lot of different ways of calling it different things. I don't really care what you call it. But somebody in the conversation made a comment, hey, there's three things that you basically struggle with in doing contingency planning. One is money can be an issue. In fact, money buys time. One reason for, particularly if you're a business owner, having personal wealth and not just business wealth, business success, is that it can buy time. And materials and then labor, so those are kind of the three areas. But I want to quickly hit a few of the ideas that we discussed in the meeting that sometimes we forget about. If we're going to have a labor problem that's unexpected, a lot of times if we've cross-trained people, that's very valuable. It's also valuable and useful to always just have a pool of potential people that we think we want to hire. That's one thing I think a lot of organizations miss, but they ought to be marketing. You should be marketing to potentials if in case you need them. It's a great contingency plan that can help you a little bit along the way, but also if you have a massive problem with your labor, that's a good backup. Financially, we talked about wealth, having cash on hand, lines of credit. Have stages to cut costs. Have events. When you hit this profit or cash flow level, when this event occurs, you cut these costs. When this happens, then you cut these. If you have stages, I think it helps us to kind of think through it. So you're looking for event triggers. You also want to build, protect personal wealth. Sometimes insurance policies can help. We had some clients join captives, which give you the ability for a lot of different reasons to kind of more effectively deal with contingencies. From a supplier standpoint, use a couple of different ones for the same lines of product, or simply have someone on the shelf ready to bring in, ready to go. Same thing with customers. I think you need to diversify, but more importantly, I think on an ongoing basis to cause success is pay attention to a pipeline. The third or the final piece is really regulatory. Is a lot of organizations and companies we work with get very involved with regulators, make friends with them, so to speak, build relationships, so at least there's understanding and balance in what's done. So wanted to share this with you, just some quick ideas on contingency planning, and I hope it's of use to you. Thank you.